Who are you?
The innkeeper's daughter. I happened to overhear you all talking about going to Palamedes and...
Did you report us to the Abbey?
Report? But you already have an exorcist with you.
If you have any business, talk with her then.
I'm Eleanor Hume, an exorcist with the Abbey. How might I be of service?
I want you to look for someone. A mother and her child went to visit the Abbey grounds, but they haven't returned.
They've both gone missing?
Yes. The mother's name is Mahina. She's a priestess of Aminoch. And her little daughter's name is Kamoana.
Hold on. If she's a priestess of Aminoch...
Right. Ever since the Abbey booted her out from the temple, she's been regularly going back to make her objections heard. But one day, she never returned home. And now her daughter has disappeared too. I can only assume that she went to go look for her mother.
And you believe they're being held at the temple?
Oh no, ma'am. I just can't imagine Mahina would abandon her daughter like that. Kamoana is next in line to succeed her, so she's had a strict upbringing, but her mother truly loves her. Please forgive Mahina for her protests. I was just hoping you could use the Abbey's resources to track them down.
I will do everything in my power to find them.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Like Kamoana, I grew up with only my mother as family. I can't help but worry for them.
Of course.
Let's be off, Miss Exorcist. Eleanor, what's your game here?
The mother and daughter, you mean? That's on me. I'll search for them myself.
I don't care about that.
Well, what then?
Why are you actively helping us decipher the book, when we're using it to thwart the Abbey's plans?
You think I might be deliberately misleading you? Laying a trap of some sort for you all?
Are you?
I think you're a lot of things, demon. But foolish is not one of them. I want to know the truth. I want to know what Lord Artorias is trying to accomplish. And there's something happening in the world right now. I want to know what it is. Unfortunately, little old Eleanor has never been deemed trustworthy enough to be given such information. So, my only option is to find out for myself.
You've got the soul searching down at least.
The Abbey and your band of rogues follow two different paths. But something tells me either will lead me to the same destination.
And so you don't see any need to lie to us?
Exactly.
And what'll you do if those truths don't line up cleanly with what you believe?
I'm not sure yet.
As honest an answer as any. Either way, it looks like you'll be working with us for the near future.
Yes, for now.
Hey, could I ask you something?
What is it?
About the Therians. I've heard you call yourself a Therian before. Is there any particular insight you have about them?
No, none. Artorias said I was one, that's all.
And that doesn't bother you?
Does it bother you?
Nope, not at all. If you're not worried, then neither am I.
I'm surrounded by freaks. But was that truly the reason Ceres chose me?
Keeps picking on Madame Eleanor. They're total opposites, so I know they're just gonna clash sometimes, but Velvet takes it too far!
You really think they're totally opposite?
If Madame Eleanor is a white lily, then Velvet is a black rose. If Madame Eleanor is a soaring Pegasus, then Velvet is a wolf in the shadows. If Madame Eleanor is a plate of spaghetti carbonara, Velvet is squid ink noodles with seaweed.
I don't follow you completely, but I think I get the point.
I'm sure you understand. The two have nothing at all in common. And since they don't share anything in common, some fighting now and then just can't be helped.
Well, they both have beautiful hair.
Okay, but we're talking a noble exorcist and an aloof demon.
Eleanor sometimes treats you coldly, and Velvet has helped me more times than I can count.
Madame Eleanor gives herself fully to the salvation of others, but Velvet is bent solely on revenge.
That means they're both motivated by thoughts of others.
How is the cheerful and talkative Madame Eleanor at all the same as the brooding, taciturn Velvet?
Both of them talk to me when it's just the two of us together.
You're just trying to be contrary.
I'm only telling you what I've experienced.
Actually, I feel that Madame Eleanor isn't really reaching out to me.
It's all right if Eleanor doesn't want to talk to you. I'm here for you, Bienfu. You aren't alone.
That just makes me feel lonelier.
You two are opposites yourselves.
Huh?
Stop fooling around.
But I'm serious about my fooling around.
I can't even call that a fight.
Don't get careless!
You too.
This recipe looks real tasty.
Scout ship setting sail.
Don't get careless!
Nothing special.
We will need to be extremely wary.
Here. but I'm this close. I will miss! Form zero! Stand up!
Shut up!
I'll finish this! No! Ready to die? Think you can dodge? Just try! Perfect mayhem! Not good! Smash them! Blades of wind, slice them!
That was a considerably powerful enemy.
This rocky shore just keeps going. Just don't step on any sea slugs, okay?
Why not? What's the big deal?
It's just that it isn't pretty. Their insides squish everywhere.
Yikes. That sounds pretty traumatizing.
Then again, if you pickle their innards, it makes for a great snack.
You eat them?
Oh, don't be a baby. You've had worse.
Forget the sea slugs. Try not to step on the coral.
Good point. Coral is alive and needs our protection.
Or maybe it's because some of it can be sold for jewelry.
I didn't mean either of those reasons. Although Manon appears similar to Maclear Beach, it was formed by a completely different process.
Now that you mention it, this area is covered by rocks.
Maclear is just your average seashore. But Manon here was made by the slow corrosion of seaside caves.
They were worn away by the waves?
That too. But mainly, it was the handiwork of a rock-eating species of coral, known as ravening table coral. Stay in contact long enough, and they'll melt your flesh right off.
Ah, so that's why it tingles every time I touch the coral.
Why didn't you warn us earlier?
Laffy said, have you been taking care of that rhino stag roast like a good boy?
Of course. I make sure to feed it every night before I go to sleep, since it's nocturnal.
How long are you going to keep on calling it a rhino stag roast?
I don't know. It's a new kind of beetle, so it's gonna be hard to tell if it's really a rhino or a stag. You're asking a lot of questions. Bienfu, do you like bugs?
Duh! I love rhinoceros and stag beetles both! What guy doesn't find them fascinating?
Right? So which kind of beetle do you think it is? Rhino or stag?
That's a tough question. But guess what? Miss Mogulu taught me a surefire way to tell.
I didn't know there was a way to tell.
Yeah, but if I do it, you gotta name it after me, all right? Come on! What guy doesn't wish he had a cool bug named after himself, right? And besides, Miss Mogulu told me that this technique is so good that it's only fair to have a bug named after you in return. So what do you say, man to man? Come on, let's live the dream!
Oh, all right. How can I say no to that? Besides, we all did work together to capture it anyway.
Yay! Thanks, Laffy Sack. All right, show me the bug and I'll tell you what it is. Miss Mogulu says you need to open up its outer wings and get a good whiff of the thin underwings.
I'm pretty sure I remember rhinoceros and stag beetles smelling really nasty under their wings.
Is it really that bad?
Why not find out for yourself?
No thanks. I think I'll pass.
Maybe you shouldn't do this after all, Bienfu. You probably just want to hog the name all to yourself! Well, too bad! A real man never goes back on his word! If it packs a mean punch, then it's a rhinoceros beetle. And if it smells really zesty, then it's a stag beetle.
I don't know about this.
Just let him do it, Lafayette. He's already volunteered.
I can do this? Just you watch! This smell is the most bad thing that ever bad-batted it!
Whoa! He fainted with his eyes still open! Hey! Wake up! Wake up, Bienfu!
Miss Mogilu, as soon as I smelled it, my nose literally exploded.
He looks like he's having a bad dream.
I spy with my little eyes a kiddo who's spying at my bewitching waist.
Oh, sorry. I just couldn't help it. What are those books, anyway?
Oh, that's a great question. Since you asked, I'll reveal the secrets of my tomes just for you. On the right, I've got my household ledger in the back and my magic encyclopedia in the front. That one I mostly use for oil blotting paper.
What's oil blotting paper?
It's a girl thing. The two on the left are my heavy book, which I use for flower pressings, and then my super pop-up book.
A super pop-up book?
When you open it, it pops out with the force of a raging river! When an enemy has me cornered, I can just open it up facing a nearby wall and pop! Instant getaway! The only downside is that it's a real pain to try to get closed again, so I haven't used it in years.
What about the book right in front?
That's actually layer cake.
Whoa, really?
Seared into its batter are precious bits of knowledge. Eating it is just as good for your brain as it is for your stomach.
Wow! I had no idea that was possible!
He's taking this so seriously, I almost feel bad.
All of your books are so interesting, Mogilu! That's really cool!
There's no end to your curiosity, is there? What do you say? Want to take a closer look?
Boy, would I!
If you really do, then say, Mogilu, I want to get to know you better.
Mogilu, I want to get to know you better.
All right, I accept. I'll reveal to you my most private secrets.
Wow, so that's what's on the other side of these books. I wouldn't have ever guessed that.
What the? What are you doing with Lafayette?
He said he wanted to see, so I'm showing him. You have no right to stand in the way of his desires.
It's my job to protect him as his vessel, especially from someone so wicked as yourself. Also, what you're doing runs contrary to public decency.
Witches aren't supposed to be decent.
These bindings with the locks on them. This style used to be really popular during the Meliodas dynasty.
Now that I know you're such a bad influence for him, I'll be keeping a closer eye on you.
If you can't learn to take it easy, nobody's ever gonna want to marry you, you know.
Like you're a shining example of marriage material yourself.
Hey, Mogilu, could you turn them over one more time? I want to see how the book's attached to your belt.
Yeah, sure.
I knew this would be big. Scout ship setting.